Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Will It Fail? In today's video, we'll be looking at charging lead-acid batteries with solar chargers. We're going to see how fast these chargers can bring a dead battery incapable of starting a vehicle to up to a charge level capable of starting a vehicle, which is typically around 12 volts. We'll be using a 5-watt MPPT Solar Battery Charger Maintainer. We'll be using a couple of buck converters, DIANN solar charger, and we'll be using this 10 amp waterproof mini MPPT Charge Controller. And the manual for this thing is actually in good English. It's Chinese made, but oftentimes the manuals really suck. But this one is actually written really well and it's easy to follow. So the main difference between a charge controller and a buck converter, a charge controller requires a battery to be hooked up in order to work, whereas a buck converter does not. A buck converter can take power directly off a solar panel in order to power loads. So I do a lot of off-roading around Vegas, and you do not want to get stuck out there with a dead battery because you left something on. So the winning solution of this video will be permanently installed on an off-road vehicle in a future video. Let's go! Okay, so for charging a battery, we're going to use the alligator clips. Let's first test the battery voltage. This is a 12-volt battery, and we're only getting 5.2 volts. So this battery is very, very low. Let's go hook it up. Okay, so just orient the panel into the sun so it's optimal, and then we'll take the black or negative alligator clip, hook it to the negative of the battery. As soon as I connect the alligator clip, the voltage will start rising.
I'm putting the battery in the shade so there is no chance of overheating, right by the irrigation system. Always water your batteries. Just kidding. Don't do that.
So it's about 12 noon right now. We're going to let this charge for about an hour, and we'll come back and check the voltage. It's been about 2 hours, actually. Let's check the battery voltage. 8.85. So we went from 5.2 to 8.85 in about 2 hours. Leave it on for another 2 hours. This needs to get to about 12 volts before we can put it back in the ATP. Alright guys, so it's 5 p.m. now, and it's probably about all the power we're going to get out of the panel for today. Let's test the voltage. What? Seven volts. It actually went down. What is wrong with this thing? This is horrible. We're going to continue this tomorrow. We'll leave the battery on the charger for the entire day, because 6 volts isn't going to do anything. Okay, so it's the next day, and it's about 4:30 in the afternoon. This thing has been on the charger all day. Let's check the voltage. So although 10 volts is still not enough, I'm done with this thing. It's been over a day. This is ridiculous. Let's go see if we can start the ATV. Let's see if we can turn it on. Well, the display lights up. See if we have lights. Barely. I don't think it's gonna start. Here we go. Not even close. That is pathetic. We need more power.
We are going to make a battery charger using a DC to DC converter, or buck converter. A buck converter takes a high voltage from a solar panel and converts it to a more commonly usable voltage, in this case, 13.8 volts. In a recent video, I used a similar converter with a 12 volt output. Click this link to see a video about using a buck converter to power USB devices and 12 volt appliances directly from a solar panel. I was able to charge a 12 volt battery, but not very far, as charging works better at 13.8 volts. So now I'm trying a buck converter made by DIANN. I started using lever nuts instead of wire nuts. They are great for mucking up circuits and can be reused without damaging the wires.
Now I have a makeshift solar battery charger. Okay, now we have a 50 watt solar panel. We're gonna hook it up to our makeshift battery charger and see if we can't get this battery charged.
It's getting late in the day, so I'm going to have to face the panel west. Monsoon season is starting here in Vegas, so I have to work fast.
All right, so it's the next day and I've had this connected for about 3, maybe 4 hours now. And I'm using these lever nuts, which are much better than the wire nuts, those stupid wire nuts. These are way better when you're just trying to quickly mock up circuits. You can just connect them, reconnect them, connect them, reconnect them, and you're not going to really damage your wiring. When you're using those wire nuts over time, it just kind of destroys your wires. I've hooked up this USB panel just so we can read the voltage easily without disconnecting my meter, because I want my meter to sit here and read the amps. So we're getting 10.7 volts. Let's check the amps. Okay, so we're currently sitting at 0.13 amps and dropping. So let's come back after an hour and see if we can get our voltage back up to 12 volts. So one thing I noticed about this is you can see that it's pulling 0.20 amps. If I leave it sit and I come back for a while, this will read like zero or very close to zero. And the only way I can get it to like start going again is if I actually take the leads and short them. Now you can see it pulls about almost 7 amps, so that's the potential on the buck converter. And then once I connect to the battery again, now we're getting 0.26 amps. So it's very strange. I don't know if it's the capacitors in this unit or if it actually needs to see a load to be able to keep pushing power, but it seems like at one point it just drops out. All right, it's 4 p.m. in the afternoon, and let's give it a final check. 11.0. Not much, but let's give it a try. Stand out, this battery is from 2017, so it's over 5 years old. This may be dead, and it's just not taking any charge. Okay, I got the battery connected to the ATV. Let's see if it starts. Dash came on. Here we go. Last time I just buzzed. Let's see if we get it to turn over. Jesus Christ. This battery's junk. Let's try something else. Okay, so this is day 3 of trying to charge a battery with a buck converter, and I think I've had it with the idea of trying to charge a battery with a buck converter. Well, with the last unit I used in my last video, we actually got current to go in the battery. But this is a different buck converter made by DIANN with a higher output voltage of 13.8. So I figured this would work better. Even off a 50 watt panel, it should take an hour and you should get a little bit of a charge. So I think we're gonna call this a fail. I'm gonna try something different. So right now our voltage is sitting at 12.1 volts. When I first plugged it in the morning, we were getting about an amp worth of current flowing into the battery. So still a quarter of an amp. Whereas this one would like start and then it would just stop after a few minutes. It powers loads, but it just won't charge any batteries. And the reason I think that this is actually holding a charge this time, or actually taking a charge rather, is if we remove the voltage, if we remove our solar input, the voltage drop should be very little. So right now it's 12.1. I'm going to disconnect the solar. Look, it only dropped 0.1 volts. We're still holding 12 volts. That means the battery did retain a charge. So even though this has the lower voltage, this is a more versatile unit. Although it won't charge the battery completely, it will give it enough charge to start the vehicle. So let's go take the battery and see if we can start the ATV with it. It's been on the charger for 2.5 hours. Let's see, and it's an overcast day. Let's see if we can start the ATV. That's awesome, so that does work. The other buck converter just doesn't do well with batteries. I don't know what the deal is. Okay, so now we're going to try charging this small car battery. The battery voltage is currently 10.2. The solar is not connected. And we're getting 0 amps on the clamp meter. So we're going to leave this on the charger, on the solar charger, and see how long it'll take to get enough juice to be able to start this small off-road vehicle. And it is overcast day, so we're not going to get a lot from the little 50 watt panel. Okay, now our voltage went up to 12.1. And we're getting 0.45, 0.6, so it's going up. 0.8, 0.9, 1 amp. The more I use this little XWST buck converter, I really like it. Even though it only puts out 12 volts. If it put out 13.8 volts, this would be the perfect unit. So it looks like it stopped at 1.34 amps. So we'll check this back in an hour and see how much voltage, see what the change in voltage is. So 12 volts is where we want to be for starting the vehicle. And we're at 12 exactly. So let's disconnect the solar. We dropped 11.9, so that's good. Let's go see if we can start the vehicle. Okay.
All right, so the battery's connected. We've had it on the solar charger for about an hour and a half. Let's see if it starts. Yeah, check that out. It works so well.
All right, so per the instructions, just like most MPPTs, you want to connect the battery first before you connect the solar. So it comes with a couple of ring terminals. And we're going to connect our USB panel as well to the battery just so we can have a voltage reference. But we'll use the Bluetooth app as well. So you can see the status LED. We have the green, the yellow ones flashing and the green ones on steady. That means the battery's connected but the solar is not connected. And by the way, this is a load, so you can actually run some LED lights, just like a regular MPPT, like a rover, like a Renogy rover or something. I'm not sure the maximum amps. I think it's probably going to be 10. It'll be 10 or 20, but probably 10. But you can run some LED lightings or a small fan off this load directly off the battery or solar panel. So the app is called Solar Life. In Apple Store, and I think on Android or Google Play, it's going to be called Solar Life BT. So look for Solar Life or Solar Life BT. And there it is, Solar Life. Connect to that. We can go into param settings, battery parameters. And this is a lead acid battery, so we're going to keep it on liquid. You can see we have lithium, liquid, gel, or AGM. So this should be good to go. Let's connect the solar and see if it starts charging. Connect our solar. This has a built-in inline 20 amp fuse right here. And it looks like we're charging at 0.66 amps. So charging balance, charged. 0.63 amps, which on a small battery like this is actually pretty decent. So if this can maintain this charge, I think within an hour, we can have enough charge on this to start the ATV. All right, so I just wanted to show you guys the load function on this little MPPT charge controller. What I wanted to show you is how these lever nuts work. I'm going to wire up the USB panel so we can get a voltage reading from our battery. Okay, so for the load output, there's a 16 gauge negative and a 16 gauge positive. I've already wired up the positive to an inline 10 amp ATC fuse. So we're going to finish the connection to the USB panel with these lever nuts. So all you have to do is open them up. There's quite a bit of force on them, so you gotta put a good amount of force to open them up. And these are good for 12 gauge wires. Put your wire in, clamp it down. That's it. That thing is not coming out. It's solid. Put down the lever. That's it. Now our positive connection is made. The panel's on, but in the app, I've told the load it's off. So it's manual control right now. So I told it to be off. So let's turn it back on. Seem to work. You have to actually go into PARM settings and then go to load PARM. Flip this toggle to on. That's it. Our USB panel is activated and our light is on. So this is a very cool little compact MPPT charge controller. It's perfect for vehicles. It's waterproof. And yeah, I really like it so far. So our battery is 11.75 volts and it's been on the charger for about an hour and a half. So let's go see if we can start the ATV. So I think it's actually gonna work this time. Okay, here we go. Hopefully this is the final attempt. Got the battery connected to the ATV. Let's see if it starts. This is using the little mini MPPT charger. We left it on the charger for an hour and a half. Here we go. Starting. Haha, look at that. It actually works. I messed around with a stupid buck converter for 3 days. 3 days. And then I used this charger for an hour and a half with a 50 watt solar panel, and that battery got enough charge to start the ATV. That's insane.
Here, we can see a side-by-side comparison of the buck converter versus the MPPT charge controller. Notice how we are getting almost double the amount of amps going into the battery using the charge controller. With the buck converter, the highest I was able to get was about 1.6 amps max. The charge controller, however, was able to produce about 3 amps according to the app. This shows the value of a cheap $70 MPPT charge controller when charging from a solar panel.
Check it out, it just started raining. There's our little 50 watt solar panel. Good thing we just finished charging our batteries. So as we saw in the video, a buck converter can be used as an emergency battery charger but should not be a replacement to a battery charger. An MPPT charge controller will monitor the battery's voltage and adjust its output voltage as required, where a buck converter will not. A charge controller is also at least 2 times more efficient than a buck converter at charging batteries. So a buck converter with a 12 volt output will not completely charge the battery, and it's not a good idea to repeatedly cycle the battery partially. So although the load port on the charge controller and the buck converter serve the same purpose, they do not operate the same. The charge controller requires a battery to be hooked up to it in order for it to work, where the buck converter does not. Also, I found that the load port on the charge controller do not have the same surge capacity or starting capacity as the buck converter. Sometimes, like when starting small motors, the load port will have a hard time doing that, but a buck converter seems to do it better. So for this video, the MPPT charge controller was the clear winner, so we'll be installing this on the off-road vehicle in a future video. Thanks for watching.